time on Lumiere for this group, and I'm spending some time now. And also, I must admit that the three S have done the wonder. Sudhaji, Sunita, and Sanjay. But I was very impressed with what Vrinda said and talked about docs for looking at earthquakes. And I thought I'll extend it a little bit more. You see, what is an earthquake? The earth is always in motion. And whenever there is a stoppage for that motion, the strains keep on accumulating. And as and when these strains exceed the strength of the rock, an earthquake occurs. And when an earthquake occurs, we record it all over the world by the seismic waves. And the seismic waves are akin to throwing a pebble into a pond. And you see those ripples, they go, and then the time taken by them, etc. I'm not going to get into that. You must have heard about the magnitude of earthquakes, the Richter magnitude earthquake. So just imagine, a magnitude 6 is something like a Hiroshima kind of bomb, that much of energy. You go from 6 to 7, energy increases by 30 times, 7 to 8, 30 times more, 8 to 9, 30 times more. So I think you might have all remembered the 26th December 2004 Sumatra earthquake, which had a magnitude of 9.3. So that is something like 40,000 Hiroshima kind of bombs going one after the other. It created a rupture which was 1,500 kilometers in length. The width of the rupture was up to 300 kilometers, and the vertical displacement was up to 10 meters. And you all know that it killed more than 300,000 people in South and Southeast Asia, and the economic losses was colossal. So what Vrinda is trying to do is very important. But let me just get a little bit more into some aspects of it. Why do animals see an earthquake better or have some perception than what men have? The reason is that we try to sense everything from our own knowledge. We see things, we stand on two legs. And the classical example of animal behavior in forecasting an earthquake is from the high chain earthquake of February 4, 1975 in China. This was a 7.5 magnitude earthquake. It was forecasted and an evacuation was caused at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. The earthquake occurred at 6 p.m. and they saved about 100,000 lives. If that evacuation had not taken place, they would have lost their lives. Now in China, there is a way of going for earthquake prediction. They go from long term to medium term, short term to immediate. What is a long term? A long term earthquake prediction is that at any place where you expect earthquakes, if an earthquake, suppose in Himalaya, in some places you get a magnitude 8 earthquake every 200 years or 300 years. So if it has not occurred for that time, that means a long-term prediction. Then you go from there to, then you do some more research, medium term, which is of the order of a few years. Then short term, few months, etc. And then immediate. So in China, they have gone through all the three stages or four stages and realized that Haicheng is an area where an earthquake could occur. Now the February month in China is very cold. And what they found that on 4th February in the morning, snakes hibernating in their burrows, they came out and they were frozen still. So that was an indication that something unusual is happening, and they made that forecast and saved those people. Now why did the snakes came out? Because, you know, a snake is always in touch with the entire body, with the surroundings. And if there are some vibrations, it will get rattled, it will come out. Now, we as human beings, we stand on two legs. So, as a science student, if I'm standing here, and even if this plane moves like this, I won't feel it. If I have four legs, I would feel it anyway. And these are the kind of perceptions. You must have heard that when this Sumatra earthquake occurred, a lot of tribes in Andaman Nicobar, they were saved. Why they were saved? They followed their animals, and the animals walked up. So they followed those animals. So the tsunami which was created did not affect them.